GS4 drives have BACnet built in. That's right, there's no extra charge for BACnet. And it's so easy. You just go to parameter 9.86 and switch the RS45 COM port to BACnet mode instead of Modbus mode. You'll want to make sure that the BACnet address and device IDs are unique on your BACnet network. Let's change our ID from the default 10 to 37 and the address to 99, just so it's obvious that we found this device. Make sure the baud rate is what you need. Our USB to 45 converter we'll be using is set to 38.4K baud, so this is correct. The COM port parameter is default to N81, but you can change that in parameter 9.02 if you need to. And of course, to control and monitor the drive via BACnet, we need to make sure parameter 3.0 is set to accept commands via RS45, parameter 4.0 is set to accept frequency values via RS45, and that the drive is in remote mode. Great! Now that we've switched the COM port to BACnet and configured it for our network, any BACnet controller on that network can now talk to our device. Let's do an example. I'll plug my USB to 45 converter into my PC, this is the one I'm using, and plug the other end of the cable into the drive we just configured for BACnet. I don't have a master BACnet controller handy, but there's lots of free apps out there on the internet that act like a master controller and allow you to test your BACnet system. Pick whichever one you like. For this video, we'll use this one. Please, don't call Automation Direct's tech support about this app. It's not an Automation Direct product, so they couldn't support it even if they wanted to. When you launch this app, you get a blank screen. First, we have to tell it which transport protocol we're going to use. So right-click and add a device. The GS4 drive uses the MSTP transport protocol. I see in my Windows Device Manager that my USB to 45 converter is on COM port 11. So that goes here. The baud rate's exactly what we want, and we'll have it start at address 0 and search for devices through address 127. Remember, we just set ours to address 99, ID 37 a minute ago, right? Click Add, and the app automatically searches for all possible devices on this BACnet network, and sure enough, it finds our device at address 37, ID 99. Perfect. If we click on our device, the app automatically pulls the device for all available BACnet objects defined on the device. Here are the analog value objects, and here are the binary value objects. I can right-click on a device and ask the app to query each object and ask it for its name. And just like that, we have all of the objects' names. If I click on one of the analog value objects, then over here, I can see everything there is to know about that object. Let's click on one of the discrete objects. Again, there's everything you need to know about that object. Analog value 1 sets the drive's frequency, so let's change that to 45 Hz. Binary value 7 enables the drive, so we'll set that to a 1. And binary value 0 is the run command, and sure enough, the drive ramps up to speed. Binary value 1 is the direction, so entering a 1 reverses the direction of the motor. And setting it back to a 0 changes it back to the forward direction. Analog value 31 displays the current frequency of the drive. Sure enough, we see it's running at 45 Hz. Well, that's about it. We now have a quick way to verify BACnet connectivity. Chapter 5 of the GS4 User Manual has everything you need to know to connect a GS4 drive to your BACnet system. One side note, we said that the GS4 drive supports MSTP protocol. That's master-slave, token passing over the RS45 network. All that means is you have a bunch of BACnet controllers, or master devices, and a bunch of slave devices on your RS45 network. The lowest address master queries any devices he wants to talk to. When he's done, he passes control to the next highest address master. When that one's done, he passes control to the next master, etc. Only masters can initiate conversations on the network, and only the currently active master, or the one with the token, can speak. Slave devices can only respond to requests. They can't generate them. The GS4 drive is a slave on the BACnet MSTP network. Click here to learn more about GS4 drives. Click here to learn about Automation Direct's free tech support, and click here to be notified when we publish new videos.